The very first inkling I had, I think I was probably 12-ish, something, 12 or 13. I was in the kitchen of a girlfriend's house, and her mom was going through the kitchen drawer, like the junk drawer, you know, with all the stuff. She was looking for something, and she pulls out this little plastic thing, and she starts telling me about how when her son was in the hospital and this thing was on her penis, his penis, and a few days later it fell off. And like, I had no idea what she was actually talking about. And I don't know if she said the word circumcision or what, because I don't remember that. I just remember that, like, what I said is just the only thing that stuck in my mind. But I was like instantly going, that's messed up. Why would you, why? And you know, I know I was like full of curiosity about it, but at the same time I was like full of suspicion. Like that can't be right. And it totally left my existence until my sister had her second son. And the first one she circumcised, and the second one she said over my dead body. So then I was like, okay, there is something they do. And I knew that it involved cutting. But of course, even at that time, oh, do the math. I was in high school, but still had never seen a foreskin. So the controversy was there. And I was definitely like automatically like, okay, yeah. She's right. You shouldn't cut on a baby's penis. That makes sense. But I still didn't have a clear, like, understanding of what went on. Then I saw a regular circumcised penis, or what what my immediate environment told me was normal. And it was normal. And I accepted it as normal. And then I had an intact lover. And from that moment, I was like, okay, that's definitely the way it should be. Yeah, it was instant. I mean, it was like a literal light bulb, you know, like when you suddenly get everything. And it was like, oh, I don't know. I mean, it was so smooth, and there was no friction, and you know, it just, I'm having a hard time not gesticulating, but it's so that you know, I'm like, my hands need to fly wild. So, now I'm gonna turn red. So,
how you Do you want me to hold the mic and you can use your hands?
No, 'cause then I'll rock back and forth.
Okay.
I'll be all over the page, and yeah, it just won't be good.
So.
So I guess you could have called me an intactivist then, because I told people, you know, that you shouldn't do that. But still lacking, you know, the information. I knew what penis A was and I knew what penis B was, but I didn't understand how they got from A to B. And I honestly, like, I would sit and think about it, and I couldn't grasp it in my mind. I was like, if they're cutting around, they have to cut in two spots, because, you know, you take that section of skin out, so you have to have two spots, and you have to have stitches. It just didn't make any sense to me that they couldn't not have stitches, because then you'd have a gaping spot, you know. And but I knew that there were no stitches, so I was just like so perplexed. And then when I finally got the internet and I saw exactly what was done, and I learned, you know, all of the horrible things that you learn, and you know, it was over. I mean, it was over before then, you know. I was really determined, and this shouldn't be done. But once I knew all the things, you know, all those details, you know, I just cried and cried. And people, by and large, they do respond really well. And there's a defensiveness, and there's things that have made this issue hold on over time, and it's still kind of there, and certain people want to argue, and that's there, but people are really responsive, and especially young parents to be. And, you know, because I've done like a lot of baby fairs and stuff, and people are just really grateful to have the information. You know, when you bring it to them and say, so that you don't make a mistake, I just want to share X, Y, and Z with you. And then they're like, oh, and they come back to me the next year with their, you know, son that they've left intact. And they're like, look, this is my son. I left him intact. You know, so, you know, people are actually really happy to have been told, because I also work for an attorney, and you know, we represent people who have been really, really harmed, and some of them infants, and it's a much worse conversation to have, unfortunately, you know, for them to say, how come nobody told me, you know, here I am with this heinous damage to my child and nobody said. And so, you know, it's, they're even receptive after the fact, like what could have been, you know, like I wish someone had told me. So, you know, you're doing the right thing.